All right, man, let's get straight into today's video because today's video is going to be filled with absolute wet, watery, heavy gems. Like, I'm talking about, I'm providing 1000% value, 1000% wisdom. And, like, I literally just got out of my 9-to-5. Like, low key, the minutes are going by like seconds. But today, we're going to be talking about how to effectively manage your time at a full-time job, even if you have a part-time job, even if you don't even have a job at all. This video is going to resonate with you. Now, as you can see on the screen right here, I got like the whole like paint or whatever. You know what I'm saying? I gotta keep you guys stimulated somehow, right? Like, I'm not putting no like edits, or I'm not like putting like Subway Surfers gameplay on the corner of my screen. Like, I'm not doing all that. So to keep y'all stimulated, I got a little paint right here. I'm gonna be drawing some pictures, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to kindergarten. You know, I used to draw a lot in kindergarten. Actually, I drew a lot in throughout all my school years. But getting off topic, today's video, I'm gonna be talking about how to manage your time because time is valuable. Time is the most valuable thing we have, and yet we waste so much of it. So the first thing you need to know on how to effectively manage your time is to always think long term. Now, what does this mean? Well, we usually think in the short term. We always think to ourselves, how can we get the best results in the shortest time? And that's a good way of thinking, but if you're gonna always think like this, you're realistically not going to achieve the results that you want to achieve. Now, a prime example of this is going to the gym, right? You go to the gym in a long-term investment. Like, going to the gym is literally an investment because you have to go to the gym. You have to be consistent, disciplined for months, maybe even years, if you want to see the results. But I mean, unless you're taking some like trend, or you have like the perfect diet and perfect workout, or you're literally David Goggins, stay hard, right? He lost like 100 or like 200 pounds in like 3 months or something like that. Like, it's crazy, right? But you got to think long term. Like, as soon as you get out of work, what are you doing? You have to resonate your habits with long term investments. Like, what do I mean by this? Well, if you're going to get out of work and then you're going to scroll on Twitter and then scroll on TikTok and then scroll on Instagram, and then you're gonna play video games, and then, you know what I'm saying? Then you're gonna eat some McDonald's because, oh, you don't have the time, right? Supposedly, you don't have the time to make yourself a meal, a nice, healthy meal, but you'll go ahead and scroll on TikTok for hours. So, you know what I'm saying? You're just making excuses at that point. So, if you wanna think in the long term, you have to connect your habits in a long-term routine, which is another topic I'm gonna get to. But basically, instead of doing short-term activities, boom, 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 think long term. And so every single habit that you do, think to yourself before you do it, will this benefit me in the long run? Will me going on the hub, is me going on TikTok, is me playing Fortnite beneficial for me in the long run? Because to be honest, like, if unless you're trying to go pro in that video game, or you're making like content off that video game, hey, whatever works for you. But if you're doing this every single day and you're not making an income, you're not providing for even not just for others, but yourself. If you're not even making a living, if you're not getting some sort of trade off of this time, then you're wasting your time, right? So this is why habits like reading, journaling, working out are so beneficial, because at first it sucks to do. Like, believe me, like when I first worked out, when I first started like journaling or reading, I'm like, bro, what am I doing, bro? Like, I'm literally writing on a tree. I'm literally like why would I do this whole workout routine if I'm not gonna see the results the next day? But if you think like this, you will literally never achieve anything. I'm gonna keep it a buck. All good things take time to build. That foundation is going to take time to build, just like your relationship with God. Hey, I don't know if you believe in God or not. Shout out to Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. But all good things, a good, strong, firm foundation is going to take time to build, just like your physique. And so we could connect this with your diet. So say, for example, you eat junk food every single day, right? You eat junk food, you go to the Golden Arches, you go to Burger Queen or whatever. And at first, it seems worth it because you're saving money, you're saving time. But in the long term, you're literally going to feel like shit. And not only that, you're going to have all sorts of health problems, bro. Like, I'm gonna keep it a buck. Your health is the greatest wealth. And so you really gotta take care of it. So although at first it seems like you're saving money and saving time, down the road, bro, When you're older, bro, you're gonna be spending your time in the hospital. You're gonna be spending that money, that saved up money that you were saving up when you were eating like Burger Queen or McDonald's. You're gonna put all that money into your medical bills because you chose to indulge in instant gratification. And it's not just content. It's literally with also like the foods you consume, just like what I'm saying right now with the Golden Arches, with Burger Queen. But if you took the time, like, yes, it does take time unless you meal prep. Hey, that's a thing. That's one of the pro tips I'm gonna give off right now. You gotta start meal prepping. Like, literally, like, if you don't have the time to cook, just like I do, you gotta start meal prepping. And although it sucks at first, like, yes, you gotta take like maybe an hour or two to cook the food, but guess what? Now you have food for like the whole week. So now you don't gotta waste your time to go to McDonald's. Now you don't gotta waste your time to cook over and over, like a fresh meal over and over, because now you have so many meals already prepped. And so this is one of the ways you can actually effectively manage your time, and that's by meal prepping. Or if you go to the store, you gotta buy in bulk. Don't just buy like I remember, like I used to go to the store with my mom, and she would always buy like the things, like the smallest items of every single thing. And we would have to go to the store like multiple times a week because she would always buy the small things. And like I would only say this is a good thing to do. It's like, because I remember I used to take so many trips to the store with my mom because she would always buy like the $1 smallest option of things. But this is actually wasting time, believe it or not. Like, yes, like not only is it wasting time, but it's also wasting your money. Now, I would only say like this is a option. Like, if you're gonna buy like the small things of things, the only reason why I could think of like you actually doing this is if you don't have like a car, which my mom, unfortunately, she didn't. But you know what I'm saying? Like, if you have a car and if you have the money to buy the bulk option, what are you doing, bro? Why not just buy in bulk? That way, not only are you saving money, but you're also saving time because now you don't have to go to the store every single day. Now you are actually saving money. It's actually cheaper to buy things in bulk. At the end of the humble day, what are you doing? Buy in bulk. Like, unless like you low-key can't control like your eating habits and you low-key go to the fridge every 5 minutes, then this might not be an option for you. But I'm telling you, bro, if you invest into buying things in bulk, into meal prepping, you're going to save so much time, and it's gonna be so much more beneficial for your health. All right, so the second way you can actually effectively save time at your 9-to-5 job, or just in general, is to start removing things from your daily life. Now, what do I mean by this? Well, obviously, when you work that 9-to-5, or even if you don't work at 9-to-5, if you do like a bunch of things that is taking away time from your day, a good thing to do is to start removing those things that are wasting your time. Because I would like to say, oh yeah, you could start adding things to your daily routine, but you know what I'm saying, like if you're spending already like 70% of your time at your 9-to-5, you already gotta go home and you gotta still shower and eat. You know what I'm saying? So realistically, like 90% of your day is literally spent doing basic things. And so for me to say add things onto your day, that's realistically not possible, right? But what is possible is removing things. You gotta minimize the amount of time it takes to do certain things. So like for me, for example, like every day after work, I go to the grocery store and buy a few things here and there. That already takes up like 20 minutes of my day. And if I add that up at the end of the week, that's like 2 hours, 2 hours spent just doing some shopping. And that 2 hours, it could be put into a video just like this, or maybe a workout routine, right? So to do that, like obviously I already talked about, like you gotta start bulking, you gotta start buying in bulk, and that will actually save time. That will actually minimize the amount of time it takes to do certain things. So for example, every single day, like after work, I'm going out grocery shopping, getting a few things here and there. But that already takes like 20 minutes of my day. And at the end of the humble week, that's like 6 days, 6 times 20. Like that's like 2 hours spent just doing some grocery shopping, and that 2 hours can literally be spent making a video or maybe even hitting a workout. And so obviously I already talked about one of the things is to buy in bulk and to start meal prepping, but another thing that you have to remove, or not necessarily remove or cut off, but you gotta start saying no to certain friends. Because I'm not gonna lie, like some of my friends may be watching this video, hey, you know what I'm saying, shout out to you, but you have to say no. You have to know a fine line between whether you want to continue wasting your time with them or you want to actually work towards your goals. because you have to choose. Like, you can't serve two masters at once, right? You either one love you either love one or hate the other. And so you have to minimize the amount of time it takes to do certain things. Like, for example, every single day after work, I go grocery shopping. I get a few things here and there. Guess what? That's already 20 minutes. And 6 times 20, you know what I'm saying? That's 2 hours of my week spent literally just shopping. And you know, that could go towards a workout. That could go towards making a YouTube video, right? And so you have to effectively manage your time. And one thing, like obviously I said, is to buy in bulk or to even meal prep, because this is where it's gonna actually save you more time. But another thing that you have to remove, not necessarily remove or cut off, but you gotta start saying no to your friends. Now, some of my friends may be watching this video. Hey, shout out to you guys. I'm not hating on anyone. But what I'm trying to say is that you need to know the fine line. You need to know the barrier between whether you want to continue wasting your time with these friends or actually working on yourself and towards your goals. Like, are you willing to trade your goals, the dream, like your actual dream life, for some fun, for some procrastination, to satisfy your friends, your supposed friends? Because I'm not gonna lie, they're not actually your friends if they don't support what you do. Now, obviously, a good friend, you know, there's a little like contradiction in here, but a good friend will actually tell you something you shouldn't be doing. Like, if there is something that you're doing that isn't benefiting you, like if you're going to the gym and you're trying to do like a whole like strict diet and these friends don't support you, then they're just hating. But if you're literally like eating like Burger Queen, McDonald's, and you're literally beating off to the hub every single day, if your friends say that's okay, then they're not realistically your friends. They just want you to suffer with them. And there's this saying that you are the sum of the five people you hang out with the most. Now, these don't have to be necessarily friends. It could be even your family members, or it could literally even be people you watch online, just like this video. You see, if you spend a lot of time with these people, you're going to become the byproduct of these people. So, like, low key, like, if you have family members that are drinking, smoking, doing all this crazy stuff, you might be a byproduct of that. You may follow their footsteps because you are surrounded by them, because this is the lifestyle you've grown up with. And same goes with your friends. Like, if your friends are constantly partying, going out to the club, like, eventually, you gotta make that choice, bro. You gotta say no to them. And if you say no to partying with them and going to the club with them and they reject you, then that's on them, bro. Like, leave them be. Let them go your way. Focus on yourself, bro. You see, it's actually kind of funny because when I started my self-improvement journey at the start of 2022, I literally found all these like self-improvement creators like Ice Cold JT, Hamza, you name it, right? And these people, I hanged out with these people the most. Like, even though they weren't there in real life with me, I was watching their content. I was literally doing his workout routine, JT's ice cold workout routine. I was doing it every single day. And I was basically like low key, like spending time. Hey, pause. I don't know. But I was literally spending time because literally his video was right there. I was looking at him work out while I was working out every single day. And so I became a byproduct of that. Like, if I'm seeing this dude with a shredded physique, a six pack physique every single day, it low key made me motivated. Like, low key, like, it motivated me to do the same. And so if you could find someone like this, like, that's why I'm trying to provide you guys with this value. I want to make like all these types of like workout routines. I want to go crazy because I want to provide the value that I missed when I was younger, right? Like, I'm low key like making this video not only just for you guys, but I'm talking to my younger self because my younger self needed to hear this advice. He needed, like, bro, if I could go back in time and tell my younger self this advice, like, low key, he would have been like the next like Elon Musk, bro. Like, I'm not gonna lie, he would have been a billionaire. But I mean, even if I wasn't a billionaire, I still would have been shredded as fuck. I'm not gonna lie. But hey, we're getting there. We're trying to get that Asta Uzumaki physique, because as the legend himself would say, we're all gonna make it, bruh. Hey, I'm getting a little off topic, but back to the point with the removing things. You gotta remove things that are literally taking up your time. Like, one thing that takes up your time is scrolling too much. You know, you don't even realize, but you literally spend probably like 20 hours a week scrolling on your phone, bro. Like, literally, you go AFK. Like, your finger is literally going a thou like your finger is literally doing more cardio than you, bro. What are you doing, bro? You're literally AFK. You're like a rat, literally, like, looking. You're like in a, like, you know how they say the rat race? You're literally like a rat in a wheel. And you literally just see, you see the goal, the dopamine right in front of you, and you keep chasing it, chasing it, chasing it, scrolling video after video after video, until eventually your brain gets too tired and you literally fall asleep. And now, like, even if you don't fall asleep, you now don't even have the motivation, you don't even have the dopamine to go read a book or even work out, because you literally fried your brain. I come to think of it, doing nothing is actually way more productive than scrolling on your phone, scrolling through Twitter, scrolling through TikTok, because you aren't actually deep frying your dopamine. Like, now, like, your brain is actually conscious, it's actually healthy, it actually has enough dopamine and motivation to go do delayed gratification. Yeah! Alright, I'll come up with two scenarios. So if you have a job, say for example, you know, like for me, for example, like I wake up at 7 o'clock and from 7 to like 5 or 7 to 6, I'm literally basically getting up, going to the job, and going back home. So I literally have from 6 o'clock in the afternoon to like 10 to 11 at night. So realistically, I only have like 4 to 5 hours of free time. Not even, because then I have to cook, like clean a little bit, clean myself, take a shower. So low-key, I only have like maybe like 2 to 3 hours a day of free time. That's kind of depressing, I'm not gonna lie, right? So of course I'm gonna need a routine. I'm gonna need to know what I'm going to do in those 2 to 3 hours, because my goofy brain is gonna tell itself, oh, you know, you worked all day, you get to relax, you could relax, you could procrastinate as much as you want because you've worked so hard. But bro, that is not gonna get me anywhere. Like, I gotta go harder, I gotta stay hard, I gotta surpass my limits like Asa Uzumaki. And so I gotta create this routine. Okay, so let's just say I get home at 6 o'clock. So from 6 to 7 o'clock, I'm gonna dedicate my time to making videos or making content or whatever it may be. And then from 7 to 8 o'clock, I'm gonna dedicate that time to working out. And so from 8 to 9 o'clock, okay, now I can have dinner. And then from 9 to 10, I can maybe like edit my video, and you know what I'm saying? And by 10 to 11, finalize the video, get ready for bed, and that's it. That's literally a day in Motives' life, while I'm working a 9-to-5 at least. And so, but if you don't have a 9-to-5, say for example, you wake up at like 10 o'clock in the afternoon, right? Okay, so from 10 to 11 o'clock, write down waking up, getting ready, or having breakfast, whatever it may be. Like, it doesn't have to be a crazy breakfast. You could literally just put like coffee time, right? And so you dedicate that hour to coffee or whatever, waking up, brushing your teeth, whatever it may be. Okay, great. Now from 11 to 12 o'clock, hey, if you're an afternoon, morning, whatever type of person that loves to work out at that time, hey, great for you. So now you can write from 11 to 12 o'clock, you start working out, you go to the gym. And so from 12 to 1 o'clock, okay, we're not going to stop there. Let's make a YouTube video. Okay, 12 to 1 o'clock, YouTube video. And then you could write from 2 to 3 o'clock, editing a video. And from 3 to 4 o'clock, uploading that video. 5 to 6 o'clock, you know what I'm saying? Like, it takes a lot of time to actually make content. Like, I don't know about you guys, but it takes a lot of time just to even, like, I'm not even putting edits in this video, just to chop it up a little bit, put a title, thumbnail, and do all that. It takes time. Like, you low-key have to dedicate at least a day to this video. And that's what I'm doing. Hey, low-key, I'm trying to speedrun this. That's why, you know what I'm saying? Like, the time is going by. So this is how you can actually effectively manage your time, by knowing what you need to do in that time. Because you don't want to rely on motivation for your habits. Because if I relied on motivation to go to the gym, I probably would never go to the gym. Because why would I want to put my body through stress? Why would I want to put my body through all this pain and waste my time lifting some heavy weights, right? That's what my brain says. But discipline and that routine, knowing that you need to go to the gym at that time, that's what's going to take you far. Because then you're going to rely on the discipline, doing the hard work, especially when you don't feel like it. Shout out to Hamza. And this is where you're going to make progress. Because I didn't feel like when I started self-improvement and all that, I knew it was going to suck. I knew that I was going to have those days where I really didn't want to do that thing, like working out or journaling or reading or even taking that cold shower. You know what I'm saying? That ice cold shower. But I still ended up doing it. And that is where you make the most progress, when you do the things that are hard to do when you don't feel like it. No pain equals no gain. Yeah, don't get it twisted. And so think of it as like a video game, when you're fighting a final boss, like a very hard final boss, and you can't defeat him, like you try over and over and over again, but you just can't defeat that final boss. And so, you know, in the back of your brain, you're gonna have to go through hours of grinding, hours of leveling up your armor in order to defeat that final boss. Now, apply that mindset into real life. In order to lift that heavy weight, that thing that is really hard to do, you need to go through weeks or maybe even months of training in order to lift that weight, in order to hit that PR. And so instead of playing these building video games, how about you go out in real life and make those gains? Yeah! But anyways, I hope you guys did enjoy today's video. Stay blessed, stay wealthy, and remember to keep surpassing your limits. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Hee!